on connecting and attracting Latin America and the rest of the world to Silicon Valley and connecting them, right? So my question here is, does this seem like a bigger challenge, right? Like to do the opposite, to bring startups and investment from emerging economies to the big, you know, economy that the Silicon Valley is? What do you guys think?
So being the position that I'm in, I'm actually consider myself to have a global perspective. I have daily, day-to-day insights as to what the world is doing because of the international network I have created thus far. And so I have the European perspective, which are my main champions, to be honest, are my main clients. And so culturally, innovation, tech is very different the way they do business. They're more accessible, they're more they're risk takers. They want to bring the best of their best to Silicon Valley. And that means that they're bringing the best, but also with capital. So they worked very hard. You're seeing a lot of incentives from public and private institutions. And just look at France. Innovation, investing with real capital, the government of France, to their entrepreneurs so they can build scalable global business models and then for them to make the jump to the valley. So those are the investors I work with directly, and those are the entrepreneurs that I'm opening my network in the valley to. Latin America is very different, and that's where I find my challenge. Because even though my heart is in the right place, it is in Mexico, it's in Colombia, Brazil, Argentina, Chile. But I do confront many challenges when facilitating cross-border investments to the US. And I want to say it's primarily because the ecosystem in the venture industry is still fairly new. But there are, you know, leaders within the ecosystem who are contributing, who are doing the work, such as Google here, to actually promote the ecosystem and see this thrive. However, general LPs in Mexico, if you speak to an executive, family-owned office, okay, well, there's a lot of time you have to invest, a lot, where Europe, the deals look right in the valley, Marisela. Is this what I'm looking for? Boom, boom, yes, okay, let's do it. I'm flying out to San Francisco tomorrow. Mexico, let me just focus in Mexico in this case. I facilitated seminars, what it takes to be an early stage tech investor. And there was a lot of ganas. Desire to want to do it, to pursue it, but there's still a lot of hesitation because these are traditional investors. What they traditionally invest in is in real estate, infrastructure, and to actually bring in the tech industry is still very scary for them. So I don't find Latin American investors risk averse. And also, you know, the legal structure in the U.S. can be very vague for them still. And so, and it's also, you know, what it is, it's them seeing a Mexicano or a Colombiano Brasileño have the first real success. When they see that happen, you just know right away that it's everyone's going to jump on board. But the people who are doing the work right now, who are putting in so much time and developing this venture industry, this is across Latin America, not just Mexico, I really believe that our work, we will see fruits of this. But I always recommend this, and this is something I've always said to entrepreneurs internationally. You have to have a global focus. You have to step out from being regional, from building business models regional, especially in Latin America. You have to attract the right investor. You have to attract the investors that know, that are looking for you. A lot of times I find Latin American entrepreneurs that are knocking on the wrong doors. The VCs in the valley, or even in Latin America, their thesis don't align with your business. They don't align with your team sometimes. So it's still a lot of mentoring that needs to happen, not just from the investor aspect, but also the entrepreneurs. And I do want to emphasize another challenge, because this is something that I'm really passionate about, and I'm actually leading a new movement on this, which is the challenge of being a woman, a young woman, a young Latina woman, and then you add on top of it a young Mexican-American woman. That just comes with a lot of more challenges as you're trying to develop a venture industry in Latin America or just in the Valley. And if we look at the numbers just globally, we only have 9% in the US, 9% of venture magic partner are women. And so that's a total of 170 women that sit as a magic partner who have the power to make real decisions within a venture capital firm in the US. So that's extremely sad to me. So I'm really proud to also lead a new initiative, which is Global Women in Venture. And it's basically creating a global pipeline to increase the number of women partners across the world. Thank you, Jenny. And it's very vital. And one thing I've seen a lot is we're starting to see a lot of initiatives of girls in STEM. But what I wanted to also create with this platform is, how about girls in finance? How about we start mentoring young women into positions in wealth management, private equity, venture capital? Typically, these are the industries that are not very much promoted to young women, such as myself. And later in life, we discovered, oh my God, I'm actually great at this. I can actually bring money to people. And then you start doing something about it. So, that's a little bit of a personal challenge.